Hello, welcome again to FAIRtax Power Radio. I'm Bob Paxton.
And I'm Ron Malero.
And we are
the FAIRtax Guys.
And we are coming to you from Big Daddy Studios in Gainesville, Florida, live here on the Wednesday. That's the 24th. Yes.
Yep.
Time flies when you're having fun.
Yeah.
And of course, if you're catching the live stream, you're certainly welcome to give us a call here. 888-787-8023 is the phone number here if you'd like to talk to us live. And you may notice that something is missing.
Yeah.
Or actually, someone is missing. We've been talking for the past couple of weeks here on FAIRtax Power Radio that today was going to be the day that we talked to Congressman Ted Yoho, who has been a longtime friend of the FAIRtax and not just a co-sponsor, but an active supporter of the FAIRtax up there in Washington, D.C. And he had graciously agreed to talk to us here on FAIRtax Power Radio. But when you're a congressman, you sometimes have conflicts show up, and he is not even in the country as we speak. He got grabbed for a delegation to go somewhere and do something, and I'm not really sure what that's all about.
Overseas, that's all we got.
But so Congressman Yoho is not here with us today. Hopefully we can arrange for a good conversation with him a bit later on. But we will continue to delve into the subject that we were going to talk with him about.
That's right.
That being the president's tax returns.
Oh, yeah.
But before we get in too deep, let's remind everyone of our email address. TheFairTaxGuys@gmail.com is our email address. Now, FairTaxGuys without the V and without the www is our new website, FairTaxGuys.com. You don't watch the show live there. We do have archived versions of all of the FAIRtax Power Radio episodes are going to be put up there. The live version is still streaming live on the Facebook official FAIRtax page, and we'd appreciate it if you would share this video, tell your friends about it, because we do need to get the word out about the FAIRtax, because once people understand it,
they'll demand it.
There you go.
The nice thing about FairTaxGuys.com is you don't have to join anything. You don't have to subscribe to anything. You just have to go to the website. And after Bob and I get home later on from the studio, they'll send me the video, and I'll post it there. It'll be there sometime this afternoon, hopefully before dinner time, and it'll be there, you know, forever. And so anytime somebody wants to watch it, they don't have to subscribe to Facebook or any other social media. There are, there are, believe it or not, people who are not on social media. Would you believe it?
Yeah, I would, actually. Yeah. My wife is one of them.
But, you can just go to that website and our shows will be there. So.
And again, now, the archive of the older shows are the Spreaker podcasts. They make a video that is just really the audio version, and you've got a still slide as the video for that thing. But as we make new programs, we will air the full video version here. So you can look at the faces that God made for radio that we have here.
That's true.
We'll be doing that. But again, the FairTaxGuys@gmail.com. If you'd like to talk to us, you can leave us a message on our FairTax Guys Facebook page. You can give us a call here live, 888-787-8023, if you're catching the live stream rather than the archived version. So let's dig in. We were going to talk to Congressman Yoho about Trump's tax returns.
Yeah.
Now, we'd like to, of course, give credit to Steve Hayes, the president of AFFT, because this is an issue that he addressed in one of his chairman's reports about 2 weeks ago. This is April the 12th. Of course, he likes to write about contemporary things, and this is going to be in the news a lot, as there are people in Congress that want to get a hold of Trump's tax returns. The problem is, Ron, they do not want to get hold of Trump's tax returns for any kind of, you know, legitimate legislative business. They want to get a hold of his tax returns so they can find something in there to hammer him with.
Yeah, but, you know, he's already released them, you might say, to the IRS. And the IRS, he's constantly under audit because it's a huge corporation. We've mentioned before on FAIRtax Power Radio, the IRS has a division, and all they do is audit these mega wealthy people. They're constantly under audit. So if there was something wrong, the IRS would have found it. They would have gone back to their, you know, their CPAs and tax attorneys and so forth. You need to straighten this out. And of course, the way the tax code is written, three people can have three completely different opinions on the same facet of the tax law.
Actually, what can happen, 50 different tax preparers can give you 49 different answers as to what a hypothetical family owes in federal taxes. Money Magazine did that, I mean, almost 40 years ago, back in the 80s.
Yeah.
And, of course, that was a much less complicated tax code than they have now. It was still much of a mutt mess that they couldn't figure it out. But it has simply gotten worse over time. And y'all have to excuse me, I'm having some issues with the computer, so I've got to look over your shoulder and see if there are any comments we're getting. I see Randy's aboard with us, and appreciate Randy Fisher doing all the heavy lifting as far as answering the comments that show up on the live streaming video.
Peggy Mosher Judd says, I've always wanted a FAIRtax. Thank you. Yeah. Well, we've always wanted a FAIRtax, but we want the FAIRtax.
Yeah, and realize that we mentioned this as well, that the governor, I think it's Illinois, is using the term FAIRtax to describe a tax plan of his that is not the FAIRtax. And AFFT is going to try to make him quit doing that. So the FAIRtax is a specific provision. It's H.R. 25 in the House. We do not have it in the Senate yet as of this Congress. We're still looking for a sponsor to do that. But you can go to congress.gov and read I think Randy says they used a new font on the bill. So instead of 133, it's down to 131 pages. It's still mostly, references to the current existing statutes that will be repealed. The FAIRtax will repeal the statutory authority to collect an income tax. It can't change the Constitution. So the FAIRtax, again, will have to be fully implemented, permanently implemented, when the 16th Amendment is repealed.
Yeah. But here's an interesting comment by Randy.
Okay.
Been communicating with Neil Bortz about a book he plans as a guide to deprogramming for recent high school graduates.
Oh, that's really interesting.
Bortz never had very nice things to say about what he called the government schools, okay? He said he will include a tax chapter. John Gaver has a new book coming out. Lots of good stuff brewing for 2020.
Okay, well, speaking of congress.gov, we keep an eye on it. So you can, if you'd like to, you go in there and you put the string internal revenue code in quotes into their search box and hit enter and see how many hits you get on that search. As of today, it's 552. We knew it would be up over 500.
552. Congress is not in session this week or last week. So they've had, if I can remember, I've got the graphic someplace, 45 days in session. 45 days in session, 500 and what?
552.
All right, divide that out. That's got to be like 12 or 13 proposals per day. Fortunately, not all of those will become law, but some of them might. All right?
Okay.
And they're constant. It shows a lack of stability in our current tax code, which businesses don't like. They like stability. They like to be able to predict what's going to happen next year with the tax code so we can plan. So this doesn't provide them with any stability.
Okay. Well, so keep that up. But let's dig into our Trump tax return topic here. This was addressed by Steve Hayes' chairman's report April 12th. And again, if you're not getting the chairman's report emailed to you, you can sign up at fairtax.org, or you can just go to fairtax.org and read these things.
They can also go to YouTube.
Okay.
That's right. The chairman's reports are now on YouTube on the FAIRtax official page.
Okay, but Steve quotes the actual statute that applies to what Congress is trying to do with Trump's tax returns. It's 26 U.S. Code 6103F, which says, and I'm quoting here, upon written request from the chairman of the Committee of Ways and Means in the House of Representatives, the chairman of the Committee on Finance in the Senate, or the chairman of the Joint Committee on Taxation, the secretary shall furnish such committee with any return or return information specified in such request, except that any return or return information which can be associated with or otherwise identified directly or indirectly a particular taxpayer, that information shall be furnished to such committee only when sitting in closed executive session, unless such taxpayer otherwise consents in writing to such disclosure. So the statute, the end of quote there, the statute really wants to maintain the confidentiality of federal tax returns. That's one of the things that the proponents of the income tax system have long claimed, that information on your tax return is private, it's confidential, and it cannot be released against your will. But there's always a way around stuff like that, isn't
there? Yeah, there is, isn't there? And it has happened before.
Now there was an article written for Politico by an attorney specializing in political investigations. His name was Ross Garber. This article was saying why Congress might not get Trump's tax returns. He pointed out that while the code that we just read up there a second ago appears to give the committee power to get tax returns, the Supreme Court has ruled that Congress cannot use its powers to delve into someone's private financial matters unless there is proper legislative purpose, and that Congress is not a law enforcement agency. They cannot seek information to try to uncover or expose crimes. So this article says that unless the House moves to impeach the president, then there's a good chance they won't get it. But there's a 100% chance that if they do get it, it's going to get leaked.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's no question. Yeah. Executive session, you know, private and confidential. Yeah. How well does that work with our Congress critters? All right. You know stuff is going to leak out. And this is not an investigation that has been brought about because of a crime, you know, somebody's accused. This is an investigation in search of a crime, or very least, in search of some embarrassment.
No, okay? It's in search of political ammunition to use against him in the next election.
Yeah, they want to find something that might might be considered embarrassing. And my point is that he's already released his tax returns to the IRS. They're working on them. They've got Gabe. Can you put that picture up of the president and his tax returns? His tax returns are not the normal tax returns. Look at this. All right. He has a number of different businesses. And then he ends up signing. All this is going to the IRS. And they have to go through all this stuff and try to wade through it.
I guarantee you he didn't do all that himself. He had some help.
He's got a division of CPA attorneys and, you know, tax attorneys and CPAs and so forth. It's not a simple thing to go through. But like I said, the IRS has a division and they concentrate on these mega wealthy people. But it's going to take them a while. But apparently Congress is not satisfied. Apparently Congress does not have faith in the IRS that they created.
Yeah.
You know, and the statutes that they continue to create almost on a daily basis. And apparently Congress doesn't have any faith in the IRS that they can do their job properly.
Yeah, but one point that people need to keep in mind here is that those who are applauding this effort by Congress, or the Democrats in Congress more specifically, to obtain Trump's tax returns and use them against him politically, the people who are applauding that idea need to remember that if the IRS can do that to this president, they can turn around and do it to anybody else. What if somebody decided that they wanted to see Barack Obama's tax returns and use that against him? Oh, wait a minute, you can't do that. That's private.
Yeah.
You know, so we get a case of if it advances my cause, it's good. If it helps the other guy, it's wrong. No, can't do that. If the IRS is there, and you'll remember, I'm old enough to remember Richard Nixon. Mm-hmm. And one of the knocks against him when they were drawing up impeachment against Richard Nixon was that he had used the IRS as a political weapon against the folks on his famous enemies list. So the people that are currently applauding the use of the IRS and to try to get their tax returns to use against Trump have been in the past, of course there are a lot of them too young to remember it, but they have been in the past targets of the IRS themselves. And the real question that we have to ask here, why in the name of all that's righteous and holy do we allow a system under which any individual's private information can be obtained and can be used against them somehow? And there's actually, Steve noted that, there's a sneakier way to get Trump's tax returns out into the public if the committee ever gets a hold of them. There's a provision in the Constitution that gives senators and congressmen practically blanket immunity from anything they do or say on the floor of the Senate or the House. So he points out that somebody could get a hold of Trump's tax returns, go to the floor of the House or to the floor of the Senate, enter that into the public record.
Yeah.
And, you know, talk about it, enter it into the public record, and the Constitution would shield that representative or senator from any kind of legal consequences for doing that. So the system stinks. It's not that we're trying to defend Donald Trump. I would defend Bernie Sanders if they were trying to do this to him. You know, it is just wrong to have a system under which someone, A, has to submit all their private information to the government in the first place, and then is subject to this kind of abuse. The system needs to go. The system needs to be jerked out by its roots and replaced with a fair tax.
Yeah, absolutely, because none of this would be an issue if we had the fair tax. Think about that, all right? There are no tax returns with the fair tax. No tax returns. So none of, even from corporations, and we're going to deal with that in our next show, all right? But yeah, the fair tax would make all of this a moot point because you go to the store and you buy something, the fair tax will be included in the price of the product, you pay it, or when you pay the plumber or something like that, it's automatic. Nobody needs to know any of your private information or your business information. It's done.
Yeah.
It's done. We've got a question here before we go on with this.
I'll say, I'm trying to read your comments, and they're a long way away over there.
Yeah. If the FAIRtax lowers the tax on the rich, which it doesn't really, and doesn't unfairly tax the poor because of the prebate, how is it revenue neutral? Okay, he's got several terms mixed up here. Revenue neutral means that it raises the same amount of money for the federal government as the current tax system. The FAIRtax is designed to be revenue neutral, which will mean it will raise the same amount of revenue for the government that the government is currently getting through its tax system. It has nothing to do with the rich or the poor or anything else.
Well, I think what he's saying, if it's going to reduce taxes on current taxpayers, how do we get the same amount of money? And the answer to that is you expand the tax base.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, the FAIRtax will be paid by people who are getting, you know, cash jobs, you know, getting paid in cash under the table. Mm-hmm. People who are not here legally. They buy, anybody that buys things at retail becomes a taxpayer under the FAIRtax. And there are evaders out the wazoo of the income tax. Yes. So, yeah, when you start collecting a reasonable share from everybody, you don't let anybody evade it. Then each individual share can go down and you can still raise the same amount of money with less from any one particular individual, because there will be some more individuals under the FAIRtax that are paying nothing under income tax but will pay the FAIRtax. So that, I think that's probably where the guy's going.
We're going to take just a minute on this one. FAIRtax completely ignores tax cheating, which will happen. How? How are you going to cheat under the FAIRtax? You're going to go into one of these big box stores and buy a big TV or a coffee maker or something like that and tell them, oh, by the way, I don't want to pay the FAIRtax on this. That's not going to happen.
The only way you can tell somebody, I don't want to pay the FAIRtax, is go to the thrift store and buy something used.
Yeah, which,
you know,
is...
Or buy a used car 100% or a pre-existing home. That's perfectly legal.
Yeah, because used stuff is not taxed again under the FAIRtax, okay? So if you buy a used car, that won't be subject to the FAIRtax. A new one will, okay? Mm-hmm. So it's very difficult, and we've spent entire shows on this. Evasion is very difficult under the FAIRtax. Unfortunately, it's rampant under the current tax system.
It is.
But let's get back to the matter at hand here.
Back to this thing. Of course, Americans, again quoting Steve here, Americans instinctively know that if a government can abuse the rights of one citizen, they can abuse the rights of other citizens. The question for Congress and the President is, why should Americans be forced to submit income tax returns at all when there's a more efficient way to run the government? FAIRtax. So yeah, get rid of the system that allows your personal information to be used against you, against your will, even if they have to obtain it illegally. If they can obtain it legally and then illegally leak it out, or obtain it legally and go to the floor of the Senate or the House and broadcast it to the world, that is a system that needs to go away. And even if it's being used against somebody that you don't like right now, the day will come, mark my word, that it will be used against you or people that you do like.
Oh,
the system needs to be replaced because it's corrupt, because it is just rotten to the core. And their only way to replace the current system is to yank it out by the roots and replace it with a FAIRtax.
Yeah, the only true tax reform in Congress right now is the FAIRtax. All right. I think there's a bill for the flat tax. The flat tax is still an income tax. The lobbyists love the idea of a flat tax. They get to go to work all over again.
Okay.
All right.
Time's flying. We got about 10 minutes left, and you got a whole bunch of stuff to get into.
Yeah, I just went through the last couple of days. I went through some of the news articles. I've called these little sections from Fox News, CNN, Politico, and so forth. Elijah Cummings, chairman of the House Oversight Committee, subpoenas accounting firm for Trump's financial records. Now, this is, he wants financial records on Trump's dealings, business dealings, and he subpoenaed them on March 20th, all right? The company is called Mazars USA, Trump's former accounting firm, for copies of statements of financial conditions and audits prepared for Trump. Several of his companies, including the one that owns Trump International Hotel in downtown Washington. The panel also requested supporting documents used to produce the reports and communications. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. When they say communications, they want all communications of any form, between anybody related with Trump. I mean, this would be, you know, millions of documents. Jim Jordan responds because Jim Jordan was not too happy that Elijah Cummings had a secret meeting with Democrats only and no Republicans invited, where they decided to do this. And he says, if you intend to continue to use the committee's limited resource to attack President Trump for political gain, I hope that you will at least be transparent about your actions, Jordan wrote. Your ability to function as fair and unbiased finder of the facts is now at grave risk, and so on. All right, so that was Elijah. He's in the House. That's the House Oversight Committee. For some reason, they think they have oversight to all of Trump's financial dealings. Then, in the Ways and Means Committee, all right, Richard Neal, on April 3rd, he requested Trump's tax returns from the IRS.
Yeah, under this 26 code 6103.
Yeah, that we talked and about yesterday was the deadline, and guess what? He didn't get them.
Okay, he didn't get them.
So. To nobody's surprise, okay? So anyways, yesterday, April 23rd, in Politico, the what they call the morning tax, which you get every morning, get ready for more letters. Treasury Secretary Mnuchin has said in the recent weeks that he is confident that the administration will have some sort of response ready for today's 5 p.m. deadline. Yeah, I bet he will, and it's probably going to be keep looking.
Probably can't repeat it here on our. So, well, I tell you what, you talk about using people's tax returns and personal financial information against. I want to know how somebody like Nancy Pelosi became a multimillionaire doing nothing but being a congressman all her adult life.
Yeah.
How do you get that rich on, congressmen make better salaries than most of us, but they don't make enough to make you a multimillionaire like she is.
Yeah.
I want to know how that happens.
It is also interesting that Ms. Pelosi has demanded to see the tax returns for the president and the vice president. Well, they're the number one and two top officials in the government. Mm-hmm. Why don't we go to number three? All right. Shouldn't we see number three?
Who would that be?
Nancy Pelosi.
Bingo. I think you just got your answer.
Somehow it stops at number two and doesn't go to number three. How does that work? The reason this is so dangerous is, I mean, these political parties are going to have at each other. You know, this started back in the Washington's administration, the first president, all right? His secretary of the treasurer did not agree on how the government should function. And that spawned political parties. It's been going on ever since. Fine, that's going to happen. We don't want this to spill over to the citizens. If the Congress can inappropriately get a hold of a president's tax returns, then they can get a hold of anybody who writes an op-ed that they don't like, anybody that criticizes them in any way. All right, this is a danger. And Gabe, can you put the Fourth Amendment up there?
Somehow I think the Fourth Amendment should come into play.
That's right. The right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated. And then it goes on to talk about warrant, how you get a warrant and so forth. All right. That's pretty clear. You know, it's one thing about the Constitution. It's actually a very simple document, and it's very clear, okay? We want to make sure that our personal private information stays that way, personal and private, okay? And if Congress can successfully force a president to hand over his tax returns, then they can do it for anybody. They've already got the IRS to legally ignore the entire Bill of Rights. Now they want the same authority for themselves. This is not a good situation, and it is bad for the Republic. It is bad for us as citizens. We cannot let this go. So personally, I hope President Trump or any president fights this all the way to the Supreme Court. It's not right. And it would be totally unnecessary. This would be a totally moot point when we go to the FAIRtax.
It would. So that's the whole point.
The whole system, issue goes away.
The system that allows this is what the problem is. You know, I do not want President Trump's personal information broadcast to the world. I really don't want Nancy Pelosi's personal information broadcast to the world. If we're going to have the kind of privacy that we expect in this country, we cannot have a system by which, A, you have to give your personal financial information to the government, where it cannot be held securely. It's just wrong. We got to get rid of the whole thing.
Yeah.
Replace it with a fair tax. Get rid of the income tax. Get rid of the IRS. Get rid of tax returns entirely. And hopefully, you know, this episode with, you know, his political opposition wanting to use his personal tax returns and financial information against him will be enough to bring President Trump on board with the idea of getting rid of the income tax and going with a fair tax. We're gonna try our dead level best to make that happen.
Yeah, absolutely. And you've seen a lot on social media. You know, I remember a post a couple of weeks ago, oh, I'll be so glad when the fair tax comes and I don't have to deal with tax returns. And some guy responds, no, we need to see Trump's tax returns. If he's got nothing to hide, what's the big deal? So my response to him, you first.
Yeah.
All right. You first. All right. If it's so important that you see somebody else's tax returns, go ahead. Put yours on Facebook right now. Let's see them.
No, okay? There should be no tax returns, period. That is not a necessary tool for funding the government. There is a better way to do it.
Yeah. So.
So we need to get rid of the whole thing. And time is flying here. We need to.
Yep.
Wrap it up.
There is. And let's see. Okay. Got a couple of minutes. The FAIRtax logo store. I like that.
Ooh, all right. That's cool. That's new. I hadn't seen that.
Isn't that nice?
Great. Zippered top and all, too.
Yep.
I mean,
yep.
You can turn that upside down and it won't dump out the contents.
Bob, you know, we mentioned Congressman Yoho.
Mm-hmm.
He carries these around in his shirt pocket. You know, I make sure that he has a supply because we drop him off at his office here in Gainesville. All right. He carries these around. You can get these at the FAIRtax logo store. You can get these palm cards at the FAIRtax logo store. Right now, there's a big debate going on within the Florida FAIRtax board about how we should revamp this. Some people have made some really good suggestions. So that's going to continue for a while. Pins, you know, that you can pin to your shirt or the strap of your purse or whatever. Several types of pens. There's all kinds of promotional materials, shirts, hats, jackets, scrolling banners, which is probably Bob and my favorite. You know, those things are great. So go to FAIRtax logo store and demonstrate your support for the FAIRtax. This is very important. You get it out there so people can see it. And, you know, because one day we're going to get these ads on TV. I mean, we're going to do this.
If you did not see last week's episode, you need to go back and look at it. There were five extremely well done videos.
Yeah.
Just hard hitting like you wouldn't believe. And so we're going to try to.
And, you know, they came out well on the podcast, too.
Yeah. I have reached out to the guy behind those things to see if he'd be willing to talk to us here on FAIRtax Power Radio. Can't
that
say that's going to happen for sure.
Yeah.
But we're working on getting his name. His name's Paul Wazikowski. Mm-hmm. Who put those things together. We're going to try to talk to him here on FAIRtax Power Radio. And
those things are 10 years old, but they are right spot on.
Yeah. Go back and check out last week's episode if you haven't done it already.
Yeah, yeah. And you can check it out on Facebook or FAIRtaxGuys.com.
Yeah, no www and no the. It's just FAIRtaxGuys.com.
Right.
The archived version of that video is there. If you want to go back to some of the older podcasts that are audio only, you can do that. But we're proud of our new FAIRtaxGuys.com web address. TheFAIRtaxGuys@gmail.com is our email address. And, of course, we have the FAIRtax Guys Facebook page. You can leave us questions and comments there.
Okay. So, I think you know how we feel about this quest for Trump's tax returns. It's a bad idea, and it's a bad idea. Yeah, political parties will go after each other forever. Okay,
that's nature.
But for us, for the citizens of America, all right, of this republic, it's a bad idea because it's bad enough that they've authorized the IRS to ignore the Bill of Rights. We need Congress to adhere to the Bill of Rights and pay attention in this case to the Fourth Amendment. All right.
Well, we've got to wrap this edition of FAIRtax Power Radio up. We are just about out of time. And do thank you for listening and watching and whatever else. So until we meet again, I'm Bob Paxton.
And I'm Ron Malero.
We are the FAIRtax Guys, reminding you that the FAIRtax is America's big solution, and once you understand it,
you'll demand it.
Oh, these income tax forms are way too complicated. There's got to be a better way. Who are you?
It's the FAIRtax. Completely eliminates the federal income tax system as we know it. No more withholding, no more payroll taxes, no more tax returns ever, no more IRS. All gone. And I guarantee you, once you understand it,
you'll demand it.
Yeah.